Hey friends, welcome to today's video. My name's Stephanie, and today we're diving into Morgan Taylor's new Splash of Color collection inspired by The Little Mermaid. So I am really excited about this review because this is actually my first time trying Morgan Taylor. So I don't know if that's crazy or not, but I have heard amazing things about the brand. And of course, I will save my thoughts at the end after comparisons. For now, let's get into the swatches. The first shade we have is Corally Invited, and this one is a peachy coral cream. So I am not the biggest fan of these kinds of peachy nudes almost. They can just be really hit or miss for me, so I'm not sure how I feel about the color just yet, but the formula was really nice. Even though it is such a light shade, I got really great coverage on the first coat, and I found these to be really creamy and buttery to apply, but not super thick or goopy or anything. So I had a really good experience as far as painting this on, but yeah, I'm still not so sure about the color. I think I like it though. The next shade we have is Let's Crab a Bite, and this one is described as a fiery tangerine pearl. So I'm not sure how well you could see it in the bottle, but there is a hint of shimmer. So it's not a full-on cream, but the shimmer is very, very subtle. And I also would not really agree with the tangerine description, but this definitely is a fiery shade. It's like a really hot red-orange with a touch of coral. And this one absolutely blew me away. It gave me one coat coverage, but maybe if you do thinner coats, you might need two. The next shade we have is You Octopi My Heart, and this one is described as a fuchsia cream. So I'm not the biggest fan of these types of colors, but I actually ended up really liking this one. I feel like it's just so bright that it wants to be a neon, but it's not quite a neon. And this one had amazing coverage as well. I would call this a one coater, especially if your nails are shorter, but looking back, I did see this kind of missed area towards the left side of my nail, so it's not super even, but it wasn't enough for me to do a second coat. The next shade we have is Ride the Wave, and this one is an aqua teal glitter. So this is definitely one of my favorites from the collection because it is just so sparkly and beautiful and absolutely perfect for summer. I would say that this is like a cerulean aqua blue kind of base, and it's obviously in a more jelly finish, so it is very sheer on the first coat, but there still is really great even coverage. It's not super sheer to the point where it doesn't look like you're wearing anything. So this does build up really nicely in two coats. I think if your nails were shorter, you could get away with two coats if you don't mind seeing some nail line, but I did end up doing a third just to see how this one builds up. And I just absolutely love this one. I definitely think it's one of my top two favorites from this collection because I just love that blue shimmer and the small holographic hex glitters. It's just so sparkly and perfectly encapsulates all the summertime vibes. The next shade we have is All Sands on Deck, and this one is described as a soft yellow pearl. It definitely is very pearlescent, so you are gonna see that kind of whitish pearly shimmer, and this is gonna be pretty brushstrokey. But I feel like this yellow leans very green, so it's like borderline chartreuse. And if you are familiar with me and my videos and my taste, I'm not the biggest fan of chartreuse leaning yellows, but I feel like this one is right on the cusp for me. So I don't mind it too much, but I don't love it. So formula-wise, it was a little bit streaky on that first coat, and even after doing two coats, it didn't really give me super full and even coverage, so I found that I needed a third coat just to even out all of those streaks. And you obviously want to be careful to apply your polish as straight as possible so your brush strokes aren't super wonky. But yeah, once it was built up in three coats, I actually really liked how bright and vibrant it was, but I just don't love the pearly finish. And rounding out the collection, we have Tell Me About It, and this one is described as a light lavender shimmer. So this is another one that I don't fully agree with the description, just because I think the base purple color is very pink leaning, and when I think of lavender, I think of a more blue toned purple, which is actually how it looks on the website, so it's definitely not color accurate. I mean, what you see is color accurate. I'm just saying their website photos are not. But either way, I actually still really love this shade, and I would say it's my second favorite, or my tied for first favorite from this collection, because I just think it is so, so pretty. I love this kind of pinky purple, even though I'm not the biggest fan of them. There's something about this shade that I think is so beautiful. Formula wise, this one was really nice and pigmented, but it was still a little bit sheer on two coats. So I did do a third, but I feel like you could still make out my nail line, especially in certain angles. Honestly, it didn't really bother me too much though, and I realistically would just wear this in two coats. But yeah, I think this one is just so, so pretty. Now moving on to comparisons, we're starting with Coralie Invited and looking at it next to Holo Taco's Rest in Peach, because that was the first shade that I thought of. But seeing them side by side, you can see Rest in Peach is just a little bit more yellow leaning. So I also thought to compare this next to Mooncat's Lucid Dream from their Technicolor Dreams collection. This one's another peachy kind of shade, but this one's just a little darker and warmer, but I would still say kind of similar. So yeah, once they are on the nail, they are all very different. If anything, I would say that Rest in Peach looks even more yellow here than it actually is. I think the colors were just being thrown off a bit. But I think this makes like a really cute peachy Skittle, so I actually kind of like these together. Next for Let's Crab a Bite, I wanted to show this next to OPI's My Chihuahua Bites, because it's another super bright red leaning kind of coral shade. So you can see just how red it is compared to Let's Crab a Bite, which is a little bit more orange leaning. But that one has a shimmer, so I thought maybe for a shimmer comparison, I could show this next to Olivav's Pixy, but this is, again, a little bit more red-leaning, and the shimmer is more pink, while in Let's Crab a Bite, it's a little bit more of a goldish kind of color, but again, on the nail, it's super subtle. So once you see them on the nail, I would definitely not call any of these dupes. Let's Crab a Bite is just a lot more of an orangey-leaning coral. So for more reference, I have this next to Cirque's Toadstool, which is described as a fiery red cream. This one I definitely would consider more like a true red, but there is that subtle orangey undertone to it. And in a similar vein, I wanted to show this next to Olivav's Patterson, because this one is described as a fiery persimmon red orange cream. So I feel like in the bottle, these two definitely look very similar. Maybe Patterson is like a little bit darker, but once they are on the nail, they just look so, so different. Let's Crab a Bite is still just so bright. I would say it's like the summer version of Patterson maybe, but yeah, definitely no dupes here. Then for You Octopi My Heart, I wanted to see this next to Olivav's Slater from last year's summer collection. This one is a bright cerise cream, but it is a little bit more red leaning than You Octopi My Heart, so not quite the same. But I thought maybe a closer color comparison would be China Glaze's Sugar Junkie from their Hello Sugar collection earlier this year. And these definitely have very similar vibes, to the point that I would say it looks very promising in the bottle, but once you see them on the nail, it is just so mind-blowing how different they are. You Octopi My Heart is just a lot more purple, and so I thought maybe it would be kind of similar to Olivav's Afterglow from their Summer Sunset collection for this year, but as you can see, it's even darker and almost looks blue leaning. So yeah, You Octopi My Heart is definitely unique to my collection. And lastly, for Ride the Wave, I wanted to quickly show this next to Olivav's Coastal from the recent Summer Sunset collection. This one is just much more of a darker cobalt blue jelly shimmer with no holo glitters. So I thought for a similar polish, Zoya's Elsa was really spot on. They both have that really bright blue jelly sheer kind of base with a really pretty shimmer and these small hollow glitters. But once they're on the nail, they actually are a little bit different, mainly color wise. I think finish wise, they are pretty similar and very comparable, but Zoya's Elsa is a little bit more of a true powdery blue almost, while Ride the Wave has more of that aqua teal leaning shade. So I wanted to show this next to a couple of recent teals for a better color comparison, starting with Holo Taco's Never Tied Down from the Vacation Collection. This one, as you can see, is a much brighter actual teal color, and there's more gold flakies to it. And I also wanted to show this next to Mooncat's Catfished from the Mermaid Tales collection. This one is even lighter and brighter and also a different formula. So yeah, just for color reference. Then for All Sands on Deck, I'm showing this next to OPI's Sunscreening My Calls from their recent Summer Make the Rules collection, which I still haven't reviewed, but let me know if you'd still want to see that. But yeah, this is the closest that I have to a pearlescent yellow, and they definitely are very similar, but I would say that All Sands on Deck is a little bit brighter, a little more green leaning, while the OPI shade is a little more pastel. And lastly, for Tell Me About It, I wanted to show this next to Cirque's Ohana because that was the first shade it reminded me of when it came to this shimmery mermaid purple kind of color. But as you can see, they are very different tones of purple. If anything, I feel like the website photos look more similar to Ohana than the actual polish does in real life. So yeah, these are not dupes, but I still really love both of them. So I think for a closer comparison, I have Cirque's Porcelain Plum from the recent MXM Tune collection. This one is much more of a warmer purple with a pink shimmer. So it's kind of similar and closer in color, but they still are just not dupes. I would say the shimmer in Tell Me About It is a lot cooler toned, almost silvery, while the shimmer in Porcelain Plum is that kind of warm, rosy color. So they're overall pretty different. And lastly, I wanted to show this next to OPI's Bikini Boardroom from the Summer Make the Rules collection. This is the shimmery pearlescent purple from that line, and it's definitely the closest to a dupe that I have for Tell Me About It, but it's still not a 100% dupe exactly. I would say the OPI is more of a true pearlescent shade, and the Morgan Taylor has a little bit of shimmer as well. That's kind of like that fuchsia color. It's really subtle, but yeah, not quite dupes. So that wraps up my swatches and comparisons for Morgan Taylor's Splash of Color collection. So I know I am a little late to reviewing this, but you voted on wanting to see this collection. I'm assuming mainly for the comparisons, but either way, definitely let me know what your thoughts are on this release. Because to be completely honest, when I first saw the lineup, I wasn't super excited about it. I don't know what it was. Obviously, I can see some Little Mermaid inspiration in here, but then I guess seeing the names, like, they just didn't really match up to what I was expecting. So there was something that just kind of threw me off about this collection, but once I tried them, I was like, okay, wait, these are actually really, really good. So they ended up growing on me, even though admittedly, I'm still not the biggest fan of the yellow specifically, and the nude, beigey, sandy color, I'm not super crazy about, but the formulas are just so good that I'm like really impressed overall. So definitely let me know what your thoughts are down below so we can chat about it. But thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.